Hi all, welcome to OIT speaking. Today we can discuss an OIT role play. Here the setting is palliative ward. You are the charge nurse taking care of a 35-year-old patient who has been diagnosed with stage 3 breast cancer. The patient is depressed and is in denial. The doctor has told her that her expected life expectancy is about 3 months. The patient is in severe grief. Task: answer and deal with patient's concerns. Collect history, medical, family. As the reason for being sad, tell the patient about foster care for her children. Educate her about NGOs who can provide financial service. Try to console and provide counseling to the patient. Help of a counselor. Here, the patient has been diagnosed with stage 3 breast cancer and she is depressed and is in denial. And you are the charge nurse in the palliative ward. So we know the patient already. So we can ask the name of the patient during our preparation time. You can ask, how may I address you during our conversation? Let's assume the patient's name is Mrs. Maria. So you can start your conversation by saying, good morning, Mrs. Maria. My name is Sarah, charge nurse working in this palliative ward. Then you can tell, for the confirmation, could you please tell me your name? The patient might tell her name. Here the name is Mrs. Maria. Then after that we can ask, okay, Mrs. Maria, how are you feeling today? Sometimes patient may tell you like, sister, I'm okay. Then we can tell her like, Mrs. Maria, I'm glad to hear that you are okay. Then as per our first task, we need to answer and deal with patient's concerns. If the patient not telling anything, then you can tell her like, Mrs. Maria, from your case notes, I found that you have been diagnosed with breast cancer. I know it must be really difficult to cope with this situation. And I would like to tell you that please ventilate your feelings. Then you feel relaxed. Then probably the patient may express her feelings or concerns. Again, the patient is not express anything, then you can tell her like, Mrs. Maria, I can see that you are lonely and depressed. Please share your worries with me, then you will be relaxed. Could you please tell me more about yourself and how are you feeling now? Probably patient may tell you like, sister, I am only 35 years old and 6 months back I got diagnosed with breast cancer. After that my husband left me. I have 3 children. I am worried about my children because no one is to take care of them. In this situation we can reply like, Mrs. Maria, it is understandable to feel worried in this situation. Being a mother, I really understand your concerns. If I were you, I would react the same way. And your concerns are reasonable. Try not to be worried. We all are here to support you and your children. Then, as per our second task, we need to collect history, medical and family history. So, you can ask like, I would like to ask more questions in detail. Is that okay? Then as per our second task, we can tell like, we need to collect family and medical history. So you can say like, you know, Mrs. Maria, breast cancer is very common nowadays. It can be due to some family or hereditary factors. Sometimes the cause is unknown. Could you please share your family background with me? Or you can ask, is there anybody else in your family having cancer? Probably the patient may tell you like, her mother or sister had cancer. If she says that her mother had cancer, at that time we can say like, yes, Mrs. Maria, that can be a predisposing factor. Then you can ask, do you have any ongoing medical condition? Then after that, as per our fourth task, we need to explain about foster care service for the children and the NGOs. So, we can ask more details about her children. So, you can ask like, would you mind telling me more about your children? How old are they? Probably the patient may tell the details about her children. Then, we need to tell her about foster care for her children and educate her about NGOs who can provide financial service. In that situation, you can tell like, Mrs. Maria, you said me that after you were diagnosed with breast cancer, your husband left you. So who is running your family? Probably the patient may tell you like she spent all money for the treatment. Then we can ask like, that is there anybody else in your family to help your children and you? The patient may tell you she doesn't have any support. Then we can tell her like, I'm sorry to hear that, but I have some solutions for you. Can I explain to you? Then you can tell her like, Mrs. Maria, we have foster care facility here. I'm sorry to say, even in your absence, they will look after your children. They will provide free food, education and clothing. You know, Mrs. Maria, there are a lot of children like yours in this foster care service. Also, there are non-governmental organizations. They will provide financial support for you. They will help for your treatment and for your children's needs. So do not worry about your children's education. Is that okay? Then you can tell her like, I do really understand your concerns. Being a mother, I know it's very difficult to cope with this situation. Sometimes the patient may agree with your suggestions. If she doesn't agree with you, you can again tell her like, you know, Mrs. Maria, this foster care facilities look after your children very well. They will provide free food, education until they are able to stand in their own legs. And I am sure your children will be safe. Please do not get tensed. I will give you the brochures about these organizations. Then you can ask her like, is that okay if I do these arrangements? Probably the mother may agree with you. Then you can ask her like, is there anything else I can help you? Sometimes the patient may tell you like she needs someone to spoke. Then as per our last task, we need to provide counselor support. So we can tell her like, Mrs. Maria, try not to be worried. We do have a counselor here. He will come and talk to you. You can express all your feelings. Then you'll be more relaxed. Don't worry. We all are here to support you and your children. And we have facilities here to look after your children. Do not be afraid. Please be relaxed. Then you can wind up by saying, thank you for listening to me. I will come back soon and I will arrange a counselor to visit you. Meantime, if you need any more help, please press the buzzer. Okay, Mrs. Maria, please take rest and please be relaxed. In this way, you can end up your conversation.